Hey friends, Kitty, and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be a project pan, which I'm super excited about. This is my first project pan, but I did do a pan that palette last year and I'm doing one this year, so I'm super excited about that. I really love the panning community. The panning community is actually really supportive, which I love. I love just hearing your support on my videos and just hearing like what you're panning for this year. And I decided to do a project pan this year just because I watched them a lot last year and I really enjoyed them. So I thought I would do one myself, and I want to use up a lot of products, which I have all in this makeup bag right here, and I picked out 18, so I want to use up 18 products in 2018. I did post a poll on Twitter maybe a couple months ago being like, should I do a use up 18 lip products in 2018 or do like overall a majority of makeup, and the overall consensus was just do like overall makeup, don't do like all lip products. And I totally get that, like a variety is good, but this will mostly be lip products. I tried to steer away from doing all the products. So yeah, that's that, and I have them all in this makeup bag. Like I said, I have them all in here and everything because I want to like keep track of everything. I'm also, this might be sound crazy, but I'm gonna have a sticky note that I'll probably put on my makeup storage of what I want to use up this year. So I'll have that there just to keep it open reminder, because I might put some of this back in my vanity for easy storage, but some of that I will keep in the bag just to keep track, and this will be easy for school to keep track of like what I want to pan, so that way when I'm living out of makeup bag again, which I'm not looking forward to by the way, I will be able to keep track of everything. So yeah, I'm gonna show you what I'm including in my project pan this year. I'm super excited about it and everything, and yeah, so if you want to see what I plan on using up this year in 2018, you're in the right place. Just keep on watching. So I think the easiest way to do this is just to dump everything out. Okay, so I won't be like including things from every category, but I do have like sort of categories. I think I have more than one thing from a category. Okay, so first I'm gonna start with blush, and this is actually the blush I'm wearing today, by the way. And yeah, so I did want to pan one blush. I just picked a mini blush because I have a couple of these and I kind of want to get through them. So the first product is from Tarte. This is one of their Tarte Amazonian Clay blushes, and this one I actually am wearing today like I said, and this one is in the shade Concept. It's just this nice pretty color and I really love this. I got this recently. I forget where I got it from. I think my mom may have gave it to me as a sample or whatever. I think it might have came in actually a set, and I love this blush. It's just a nice, pretty, almost peachy, warm blush pink color, which I love. That's kind of a slight swatch of it. It's really hard to swatch and everything, but you can see it on my cheeks. It's just that nice, pretty blush color. It's kind of like warm, nude peach color. I have no idea. I'll try to find what it's described as online. I don't know if they sell this in a full size blush, but I do want to still pan it and everything. I feel like I could get through this maybe by mid-year, end of the year, so I feel like that's very doable, and I think this will be one of the blushes I gravitate towards the most. I love the mini blushes from Tarte. They are so amazing. I love them so much, so I do want to pan this year. I feel like that's a nice goal to have. Now on to highlight, I have two that I liked to pan this year. One is full size, one is sample size. So first, starting off with the sample size one, this one is from Milk Makeup. I've had this for ages since I subscribed to Birchbox, so I just have a tiny bit left. I feel like I could get through this maybe in the first quarter of this year, so I feel like that's very doable, maybe in a month. I use this pretty much every day, so maybe I could get through it in a month. I'm not really sure, but I'm really excited about this, and I feel like I could pan this very easily. I feel like it's a very doable goal and everything. So the next highlight I decided to put in the project pan is the Lunch Money highlight from ColourPop. I haven't used this in a while, but I've been really into like liquid type highlights, and this is more of a liquid to powder highlight. You kind of put it on and then it like dries to a powder. I don't know if you can see that highlight, but it just looks like this. I do have a little bit of a pan in it and everything, and I just love this highlight. You can tap it in with your fingers or beauty blender, which I love. Like I said, it just looks like that. It's kind of like a nude glow, like kind of white highlight. I don't know how to explain this. This is their Super Shock Cheek highlight, if you're wondering. I do like this formula, but I've also found new formulas that I like better, so I do want to get rid of this year. I feel like I could probably, if I really literally use it every day, even if it's just a base, which I tend to do with liquid highlights anyways. That's what I do with this one. I feel like I could finish this off maybe in the first half of the year. Maybe by summer I'll have this done. We'll see. So next I want to pan, or I guess get rid of, an eyeshadow crayon, and this is from Maybelline. This is the Maybelline Color Tattoo 24-hour concentrate crayon in Barely Beige. It just looks like this, and this is the amount of product I have left. So I feel like if I use this every day as a primer or even as a base to get rid of any veins in my eyes, which I don't have a ton of, but I do have more discoloration, I feel like I could use this up in maybe the first half of the year. So I'm gonna really work to use this. Basically it just looks like that. It's not completely matte, but it is like a nice nude glow, and it looks nice under shadows. So I really want to use this up because I've had it for a while and I don't want it to go to waste. Then I have two eyeshadow like mini palettes. So the first one is from Coastal Scents, and this is the Revealed Smoky palette. I got this in a Birchbox literally last year around this time, and I have not touched it at all. And this is what it looks like. Kind of reminds me of the Naked 3 palette. Now the color I really want to focus on is the left color. This little, like, I guess you could call it like a rose gold type shade. I'm gonna try to swatch it. That's kind of what it looks like. It's really hard to swatch. It doesn't really swatch the best. Now I don't know how I feel about this. I don't know if I'll even be able to use it up. I feel like it's doable. I'm not gonna worry about that shade because I actually hate that shade. Like, I've used it a couple times, but I just am not a fan of it. I don't like it. It's really patchy looking. So I'm gonna attempt to use this up, but I don't know if it'll happen. If I don't like the quality, I'll just like declutter it at all. Then the next eyeshadow I want to declutter is the Cover Shot Golden Hour eyeshadow palette, and this was the one that was in collaboration with Shay Mitchell, but they do put this in the permanent collection. It doesn't necessarily have her packaging on it anymore. And yeah, so this is in Golden Hour, so you have the shade turned on and psyched. So that's what they look like. They're actually quite pretty, so I'm excited to use these. They would be nice, like, I feel like the other color would look great in the outer corner, and then the first color would look good on the lid, so I'm definitely excited to try these out. They look so gorgeous in the pan, and I've always wanted to try these eyeshadow palettes, but I haven't yet. But I really want to try it, and I feel like these would be just great everyday eyeshadows, so I'm really excited to try this out and everything, and I would love to get this panned by the end of the year. Both of these eyeshadows, I feel like I'll more likely get them panned by the end of the year. Okay, so this is the last non-lip product, and this is the Benefit Gimme Brow. You can't currently get this because they took it off the market since people were using this on their eyes and they were getting eye infections, which, I'm sorry, why? Why would you put it on your eye? It's meant for your brows. Sorry, but I keep saying that in videos, but I really don't understand it. And yeah, so I find it in shade 5. I really love this. I think it's a great brow gel, but I do want to use it up and move on to something else. I want to try more affordable options for brow gels. I do like the L'Oreal one, but I want to try the Essence one next, so I'm trying to use this up, and it's getting to the point where I'm almost halfway gone with it, so I feel like by half a year I should have this used up. Even maybe in a few months I should have this used up, so I feel like that's very doable, and I feel like I can do it. And yeah, this is what the wand looks like. Just a very small wand, which I love. Very comparable to the Essence, so I'm really excited to, you know, try to use this. Oh, I lied. I have one more non-beauty product. So the next one. So yeah, I do want to use up a sample mascara. So the next one I'm trying to use up is the Benefit Roller Lash. I also have a full size of this, and once I use this up, maybe I'll move on to that. But I do have two open mascaras right now, so I'm trying to use all of these up. I'm actually wearing this on my eyelashes right now. It looks so good. And I have a good amount of product in there, so I feel like it'll take me maybe half, maybe 3 months to use up, because that's how long mascaras last. And while we're on the subject, I feel like high-end mascara is better off to get like the smaller mascara, because mascaras dry out and you get so much product in the regular mascara. Just saying. And yeah, so this just really gets into your lashes. It's a curling mascara, so it works very well for curling your lashes. You don't even need an eyelash curl, which I love, because I don't really like using eyelash curlers. It's not my thing. So yeah, I do really like this, and I think it's a great mascara, and I do really want to use up this little baby of it because it's a really great mascara and I just really love it. Okay, so now finally on to lip products. I'm gonna just speed through this because I have a lot. So the first one is from Clinique, and this is a sample of the Clinique. I don't know, it's like their lip balm. I think this is in Black Cherry. I have a tiny bit of this left, and I really want to just use this up. I honestly feel like I could use this up this month. So yeah, I just have a little nub of it left. I'm actually going to put some on over what I'm already wearing because my lips are chapped. Accutane problems. But yeah, I feel like this will only take me maybe a month to use. I'm definitely going to use this like on days where I don't feel like wearing like a real lipstick. And I just love it because it's very moisturizing and it's definitely doable to use. So I'm really excited to use this up because I've had it for ages. Okay, another like lipstick, lip balm type product is the CoverGirl Oh Sugar and Jelly. I really want to use this up. I have a ton of product of this, so I feel like it might take me the whole year. But I feel like this is going to be my everyday kind of lipstick color just because it applies very nicely on your lips. It's a very sheer wash color, which I really love. And I just feel like I could use this up in like this year because look how much product is left. I feel like I could do this. Another lip balm type product is the Benefit Posy Balm. I just used up Lolly Balm and I've had Benabalm like used up for ages. Benabalm is definitely my favorite out of the trio. And I have quite a bit of this left. It's more of a peachy, brighter pink color, but I really love it. Like the others, it's just a nice wash of color. It looks so nice and everything. And I'd really love to use this up. Again, it'll be my everyday kind of lip color when I want just a wash of color. And this one I typically keep in my purse, which I might switch in between my purse and backpack. I'm not really sure right now. Okay, so I think this is the last wash color lipstick type thing. This is from Bare Minerals. This is their Loud and Clear Lip Sheer, which I really liked at a time. And I think I have a backup of this. So I'm gonna try and use this one up. And I don't think I have much of this left. Oh, I lied. I have a ton of this left. And this one is in Pink Pulse. I might also like switch this out when I finish it with the red one, because I've had that one for ages as well. It's very comparable to Benabalm, but I do like the Benabalm better. But yeah, I have quite a bit of this left, so I do want to try and use it up. It's a nice wash of color for when you don't really want much on your lips. And like I said, I have a ton to go through, so I'm hoping to use this up maybe in the first half of the year, maybe the end of the year, I'm not sure. Okay, so now on toward liquid lipsticks. I didn't want to go too crazy, so I just went with minis, and I feel like that's a very doable goal. So the first mini I want to use up is the Bare Minerals Infamous Liquid Lipstick. Their liquid lipsticks are very, like, I guess, like, wearable and everything, and they're very comfortable on your lips. This one is, like, I guess, a cool-toned mauve-y pink. I don't know, like, it's kind of warm tone, kind of cool tone. So I do want to use this one up since I don't really use it much, and I feel like I could definitely use this up by the end of the year. And then also, I have a backup of this, so I do want to use this up, and I want to use up the Tartas Lip Paint by Tarte, of course, and this one is in the shade Birthday Soup. This was their lip product for 2017 for their birthday gift. It just looks like that, and I really like to use it up. It's kind of nude mauve color, which I love. It's a great everyday liquid lipstick if you like wearing liquid lipsticks. So I feel like I want to use that up this year. I feel like I just want to, you know, get more use out of it. So I'm definitely wanting to try use it up. Then I have four just regular lipsticks. The first one is from Maybelline. I've had this one for years. This is Petal Rebel. It's like a warm pinky color. It's that like in your face pink color, but this is like a light swatch of color. It's like a lipstick, but it also is like lip balm at the same time. And I have another one of these, and I have a lot of products, so I'm hoping to use this up by the end of the year, but who knows, you never know what can happen. Okay, so the last three are minis that I would like to use up. The first one is from Benefit again. This is the Benefit Their Real Double V Lip. This is like a lip liner and lipstick in one. You have two halves of a color. This is all the product that I do have left. One is like a pinky shade, another one is like a true mauve. This one's in the shade Lusty Rose. I would really like to use this one up this year. I got it as a sample last year. I would love to use it up because I just want to use more lip products up, and I do really like this, but I would repurchase it anyways. But I'm hoping to have this done by maybe the middle of the year. Just looks like that. Like I said, it's like a rosy color. Then the last two are actually both from Bright Beauty, and these are both minis. The first one is in Thustle, and then the second one is in Nori. I love both of these lipsticks. I'm just going to show you all at the same time just so you can see. I have about maybe the same product for both of them. This one's Thustle, like I said, and this one's Nori. I feel like I can maybe use both of these up by the end of the year. This one, I feel like I'll get a lot of use of in the winter time. And this one, I might too. Actually, this one I could use all year. This one, mostly in the winter and fall, I'll get use of this. So there might be breaks when I don't use this one and then stuff like that. But I'm gonna try my hardest to use these both this year. I feel like this one I might be able to use sometime in the summertime. And then this one I might be able to use up maybe in the winter, but probably late fall. And yeah, those are what those look like. I love them both. And yeah, those are all the products that I am including in my project pan, my first ever project pan for 2018. Like I said, I am doing a pan the palette, so I'll also have that link up above. Now before I go, I do want to talk about like how I'm going to do this. So I'm going to update you quarterly. So I'll update you probably like spring, summer, fall, and winter. So I'll update you kind of quarterly on these products and everything like that, and I'll show you how I'm using them, and I'll give you updates like 4 times a year. I'm not gonna do, maybe I'll do more updates in the summertime if I find that I'm using things up faster, maybe I will, but I don't think I'm going to. So there's that. So you get updates every once in a while, so turn on your notifications if you want to know when these go up. And also I might do like mini updates more frequently on Instagram stories and stuff like that, so definitely follow me over there. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, comment down below if you're doing a project pan or a pan that palette. I'd love to hear about it. And please subscribe if you haven't already, because you don't want to miss any of these videos, and you also don't want to miss any videos of 2018. You don't want to miss it at all. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you're enjoying 2018 so far. And yeah, I will see you in my next video. Bye.